But I can't believe my ears to hear Oliver Stone talk about Hugo Chavez as some sort of hero, someone he admires, someone that that he thinks is a good guy, that he likes. I mean, this is a guy that he didn't win elections. He stole elections. Hugo Chavez isn't about reform. He's about manipulation and intimidation. So the first thought is why is Oliver Stone glorifying a guy like Hugo Chavez, a guy that wants to help supply uranium to Iran, that allows drug smuggling through his country's airspace, that supports the FARC?
We don't.
Well, Jesse, I guess we'll get to you in a minute.
Yeah, we will.
But, you know,
it's
I don't
two
understand.
Two against one, so let's be fair.
All right. I don't understand why Oliver Stone, who lives in a country that affords him the ability of with freedom of speech, to go out there and make movies, would glorify someone like Hugo Chavez that doesn't support the people of Venezuela. He manipulates the people of Venezuela. I am shocked and disturbed, cool. frankly, that this movie was made and others that Oliver Stone made to try to glorify some of these people who would like to see our way of life completely changed.
It is a kind of two against one here, so Oliver will be allowed to defend his opinion, but Jesse, would go to your thoughts.
Here. Well, first of all,
you know Chavez?
Representative, it's governor, thank you.
Do you know?
There you go.
Do you know?
I prefer my title, as you do yours.
Governor, do you
know
Chavez?
You can call me Connie, Jesse.
No, I've never met Chavez, but I will make this statement. I watched Oliver's film this weekend. And I think this film should be mandatory viewing for every high school senior in the United States of America.
Governor, Oliver, is he right? Could this debate
Absolutely.
Take place in Caracas?
Yes. Three quick points. Absolutely. It's the most colorful media. You can say anything you want in Venezuela. Anything. Number two, he didn't steal the election because you know what? They have a better election process than we have because they not only have electronic voting, but they have a paper ballot that comes from the electronic. So they have a two-fold system. It's always and it's been monitored by three international organizations. So forget about elections. And then-